Well, 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 what's good, guys? We're back, another video here, after, annoyingly enough, the video that was meant to come out today getting corrupted, and me being pissed off, and not being able to retrieve the fucking video, because my fucking computer's stupid, we're back with another video, so let's go. I'm counting on Jimmy Carr to help my day get from annoyed to happy again. So, Jimmy, I'm counting on you. I hope you got this. This is the very best of Jimmy being funny. I'm counting on you, Jimmy. Please. Don't let this video corrupt itself, I swear to God.
Moral arbiter on this one, Birmingham, right? You be the moral arbiter on this one this evening. I've got a friend, he got dumped by his girlfriend. She ended their relationship just because he said something. Mm-hmm. They were making love, they were mid-coitus. Mm-hmm. Fucking. As he orgasmed, as he arrived, ejaculated, came. Mm-hmm. Most intimate, but also the most vulnerable time for a man, as that occurred, as he...
Yes.
He said, bang, and the dirt is gone. I can see two distinct groups of men. There's some men looking at me as if to say, I don't think that's that bad. I think maybe she's overreacted a little bit. And then I can see other men looking at me as if to say, note to self. You've got to be very careful with jokes in the bedroom, because it's...
This is why I decided to react to a Jimmy Carr compilation. First joke, I'm already laughing. Let's fucking go. that's great.
It's quite funny to say to a girl who's sucking you off, it's rude to talk with your mouth full. But it's even funnier if she says, well, it's not full. Are there any couples in this evening? Give us a shout, the couples. Oh, lots of couples in tonight. This is a bit silly, I think. But for Valentine's, I got my girlfriend sex vouchers as a present. I didn't realise they were transferable. Turns out they accept them at her work. You get to the stage in a long-term relationship where you want to experiment sexually. But, you know, it can be awkward. And what if she finds out? I'm 10 years into a relationship now. Anyone be there? Anyone longer than 10 years?
Yes.
What's the longest we got in the room?
13.
13?
26.
26. Anyone more than 26? 28? More than 28? How long?
46.
Sorry? You've been together for 43 years?
God damn!
I think, come on, 43 years.
Yeah! Oh, like shit! God damn! I should say, just for the sake of, you know, people get annoyed at me for saying this, but, like, I gotta keep it real. I've seen, like, this joke right here, I've probably seen some of these jokes. That's just how it goes with compilations. I have the memory of a goldfish, though, if I probably forgot a lot of these too, but regardless, should say that. Like, I already seen this one, but I forgot about 43 years or whatever.
Now, I don't know what it's like after 43 years. I think that's an extraordinary commitment, especially in this day and age. That is quite something. But I don't know if it's the same for you, because I've only been together with my girl for 10 years. But things have got quite predictable in the bedroom. Now, when I lower my entire ball bag into her mouth, she is pretty much guaranteed to wake up. Same? Oh, you couldn't see that,
yep.
You just wait.
Yeah. I forgot about that.
You look worried on their behalf. They've been married 43 years. Don't panic. They've tried everything. What's your relationship with them? What, how do you know them? That's your mum and dad. That's nice. Well, I hope the image of your dad teabagging your mum hasn't...
I just gotta say, I'm positive I said this before. It takes a brave person. Like, it takes a really brave, brave person to genuinely be like, yeah, you know, it is what it is. I'm gonna take my parents to a Jimmy Carr show. You know, like, nah. I ain't taking that chance, bro. I ain't taking that chance. No way. Not gonna happen. I refuse. Like, let's be... must be real. There's a lot of places that I'll take my parents. There's a lot of comedy shows I'd go to take my parents. Jimmy Carr is not one, because as fun as it can go very wrong very quickly. That's what I've learned by watching these videos.
I hope. I, for one... I don't know about looking your parents in the eyes again. I don't think you'll be able to drink tea. Hi. Shit, sorry. This will be hard for you to believe. I used to be a gentleman. I didn't used to talk about my sexual exploits, even with close friends. Never kiss and tell.
Fake news.
Just keep, you know, keep it private. It's private life for a reason. Private. Now, I'll talk about anything. It's great for me because it's a catharsis, but also I think it's good for everyone because you talk about things, everyone feels a bit more open and a bit more normal because, you know, there's weird things. Here's an example of an intimate detail I don't mind sharing with you. My girlfriend can't have orgasms during intercourse, but it's not a problem because I can.
That's great.
I gave my girlfriend an orgasm and she spat it back in my face. I got into an argument with my girlfriend. She said, "You treat this house like a hotel." I said, "I have never snorted cocaine off a hooker's tits in this house." I told my girlfriend the top she was wearing was too revealing. I said, "Jimmy sometimes cries after sex." We got into a row. You'll be familiar with this. If you're in a long-term relationship, this is the kind of scenario for a row that I think happens a lot. We got into a fight on the way back from a party. So we went to this amazing party. It's about 2:30 in the morning. We're driving home. So I'm driving. I haven't had anything to drink, stone cold sober, driving. She's had quite a lot to drink. I mean, in terms of units of alcohol, she's had an awful lot to drink. But she's not drunk. And I know she's not drunk. I know she isn't drunk because she told me she wasn't drunk. 400 fucking times.
That's facts. That is straight facts. the more drunk they are, the more they gotta say, "Nah, I'm not drunk. I'm good. That is straight facts. We're back. Sorry for the cut. Had to go deal something. Anyway.
A lot to drink, but she's not drunk. And I know she's not drunk. I know she isn't drunk because she told me she wasn't drunk 400 fucking times. You know, like sober people don't. Anyway, the worst thing about this argument, I didn't even say anything. Someone else said something, and she was talking about that, and I just agreed with the fact that the other person said. And it was a fact. It wasn't a point for debate. It was a fact. So I was driving along, right? She's talking a lot. I'm listening a little. Okay, my bad. But she's telling me about the evening in real time. And I was there for most of it, so I don't need to be hearing this. A lot of the stories involve me. Right, so we're driving along, she tells me this story, and she got to the point, she said, this mutual friend of ours, this girl that we both know, she said, that girl said my dress was short. I went, yeah, it is.
Nah, you fucked up. You're
taking her side. Why don't you go back to the party? Why don't you drive her home?
You fucked up. Listen to anybody who doesn't know any better yet, let me tell you something. Anytime two ladies are arguing, you as the guy, you shut the fuck up, because you don't want to be involved in that. Trust me, the drama is insane. Like, for real. Nah, you fucked up.
You're taking her side. Why don't you go back to the party? Why don't you drive her home? It was short. I mean, it was a really short. It was what I would call a greyhound. You call it a greyhound? When it's just an inch away from the hair? It was a really short skirt. So, like, I went, it is short, yeah. She went, oh, you're taking her side? Why don't you go back to the party and drive her home then, if you fancy her so much? Try not to mind me, you're saying I've got fat legs. Suddenly yep. Fucking Chewbacca's in the car. You never fucking fancy me anymore, you know the game. What the her phone. There's just snot and...
I remember this joke, but it's still fucking hilarious. That's... it's funny because it's just true. Like, it's just real. Like, most people watching this have had similar situations to that happen. Like, it's just funny because it's real.
Next thing I know, like, within 20 seconds, she's pulling on the car door. We're doing 40 miles an hour, middle of nowhere, 2:30 in the morning. She's going, I'll walk home. I'll walk home, trying to open the car door. She's opening, she's not wearing a seatbelt because she's pissed. Opening the car door.
Hey, I learned pissed means... Actually, was that from this... That might have been from this joke where I had a bunch of people explain to me that pissed in the UK means drunk. Because, like, funnily enough, in America, if you're like, yeah, I'm pissed, it's like, oh, I'm mad. Like, I'm fucking angry as shit. Versus out there, it's like, yo, you're drunk. You're gone. Like, you're done. Like,
Nowhere, 2:30 in the morning, she's going, I'll walk home, trying to open the car door.
Shout out to you guys for teaching me that stuff, too.
She's pissed. Opening the car door, safer. opening the car door, I had to stop the car. Because it's dangerous, right? So as soon as I stop the car, she fucks off out, immediately. Teetering on heels up the road. No coat, no money, no keys, no idea where she's fucking going. I'll walk home, you don't even fucking care, I'll fucking walk home. Oh, I'm. So I have to do the dutiful boyfriend thing of driving along at 4 fucking miles an hour. Come on, get back in the car. It's all my fault. It's not my fault, I've done fuck all here. Come on, get back in the car, I'll buy you chips. Please just get back in the car. Anyway, long story short, I got arrested for curb crawling. I don't know about you, but I think the best thing about a big, passionate argument is tumbling into bed together afterwards and lying in cold, grim silence until dawn. Are you asleep? I can't sleep. I'm too full of hate. Any fans of makeup sex in? Anyone had good makeup sex? Give us a shout, yes? Makeup sex is pretty awesome, but timing is critical. Because if you get overexcited and you go for the makeup sex too early and the argument's still happening, that is a little bit rapey. I often get asked about heckles. That's a very common question for me. People want to know, what's your favorite heckle? What's the worst heckle? That kind of thing. I was doing a gig last year on the Rapier Wit Tour, the last tour, and I was doing a joke about the Paralympics. Now, when you're doing a joke about the Paralympics, you've got to be a little bit careful when you're setting up a piece of material like that you're not fuck-witted, disrespectful. So I was setting it up quite carefully. I'd got one sentence in. All I said was, my favorite event at the Paralympics. And this guy at the back of the room, quick as a fucking flash, went, Gripple jump. I wish I hadn't, but I fucking pissed myself.
That's great. I'm guessing the Paralympics is like the Olympics for people who have, you know, whatever thing crippled about them. That's what I'm guessing. If that's true, then that's funny as fuck.
At the back of the room, quick as a fucking flash, went, Gripple jump. I wish I hadn't, but I fucking pissed myself. The other one I loved, I was doing a gig last year in Cardiff, and front and centre, this guy front and centre, where you're sitting there, madam, out of nowhere, 20 minutes into the gig, he just went, Dragon. So there wasn't a massive pause before he said dragon. It was just to let you know what happened there. In my head, I had to go, whose court is that jacket? To get it started in my head. But 20 minutes in, he just went, Dragon. I went, what? He went, Dragon. I went, yeah, but what do you want? He went, I'd like a joke about a dragon, please. And he said it like I was a cunt for turning up in Wales without any dragon-based humour.
Oh my God.
So in the interval, I felt duty-bound to go and write a joke about a dragon. Do you want to hear my dragon joke?
Yes.
Okay. Two dragons walk into a pub. Don't panic, John, it makes sense. Brilliant. Oh, I love John. I'm just imagining a funeral court, you know, what do they call it when the funeral, when the, all the cars? Procession, yeah, funeral procession with drum and bass. Has your hearse got blue lights underneath it? I think that'd be quite good. That'd look like it was haunted.
For
two drag.
What's next? It could be like this hearse needs to have super tinted windows. You know, matte black. No more of this like, you know, simple normal black. We need the most like matte black possibly can get. Fucking iced out rims under. Like, just, I'm just imagining just some, like, fucking hydraulics on the motherfucker, too. Just some, like, lowrider, fucking classed out, fucking hearse.
Dragons walk into a bar, one says to the other, "It's hot in here." The other one says, "Shut your mouth."
That was funny. That made my day better than the fucking video I was trying to record getting corrupted. That definitely improved my day a lot. Anyway, give me a fat ass like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, all that fun stuff. Please, computer gods, whatever god, don't let this video get corrupted. I beg you, if you actually see this, things went well for me. I hope you guys have a great day. Bye. With the